Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 38. This week I'm entering the world of iPhoneography and post-processing an image that I took with my iPhone 6 as I got off of the Aero train at the Washington Dulles International Airport in Washington, D.C., outside of Washington, D.C. I took this just a few days ago as I was returning from an almost two-week trip to Colorado, and the scene caught my eye. So, of course, I stopped, I took out my iPhone, and I took a picture. I have been watching, I want to start this, my edits, with a new workflow. I've been watching some videos by Serge Ramali, who I have also purchased some adjustment brush presets from, and he's got an interesting workflow that I've been playing around with today, and I'm going to do that with this photo. The first thing he does is he comes over into the basic tab and he decreases highlights all the way to minus 100 and then opens the shadows plus 100. And then he sets his white and black points, which I do with all of my photos, but as a reminder, a great way to do it is to hit your Option key, and as you hit the slider and move it to the right for the white on the white slider, as soon as you see some color come into the photo, you have now that indicates white points have been set in the photo. Same with the black, slide to the left, and as soon as you see some color enter the photo, those are your black points, so you have true black points in your photo. And then I'm also going to come up here and set the white balance. It's a little greenish cast, so let's click on auto and see what happens. And it does a good job of removing that. So at that point, this is, and then I'm also, I'm also going to increase the clarity a bit and just bring up the midtones. So this is the photo where I'm going to start, and from there, I'm going to do some cropping and then using some local adjustments. So let's go into the cropping first. I come up to my crop tool, and I want to give it more of a panoramic view. So I'm going to hit the 16:9 ratio. And because the interest is the area, the lower part of the photo, I'm going to pull the crop down here. I'm also going to bring in the crop and get rid of the pillar on the left. And it's a little bit cockeyed, so I'm going to enter a value and straighten it out. And then I use this crop overlay that you see. If you hold down your O key, you can cycle through the different crop overlays in Lightroom. This is, again, different overlays, grid for straightening. There's the rule of thirds. I tend to use the triangle overlay quite a bit. And if you hold down your Shift key, it reverses the direction of the overlay. So the object is to put your focal points or focal points within the different triangles. And as you can see here, my main focal point is actually this long area of the train. These are minor focal points, but everything kind of fits in nicely. And I can move this crop around and make them fit where I want to if I want to do this. But this lines up really well. So I am going to click Done. And there's the photo at this point. So there's the before. And there's the after at this point. Now, I'm going to come in and I'm going to use an adjustment brush. And to do that, I'm going to click here. And last week I used adjustment brush presets, again from Serge Ramali. And because I didn't do a video, you didn't really get to see them in action. But here, how I access those is I go down here to Effect, and here are all the different presets that I have loaded into Lightroom. And the first one I'm going to use is going to be Enhance. And I click on that. And I want to click here, Show Selected Mask Overlay, so that when I paint on the areas that I want to enhance, I'll be able to see where they are. And you'll see here are the values for the preset that Serge has put together. And I'm just going to come in here and I'm going to paint over the areas. Now what I want to enhance is the train and I'm going to do this rather quickly. And I love the reflections in the floor, so I'm going to brush there as well. And I'm even going to brush over here. And there we go. So we've got that all colored in. And I'm going to uncheck the mask overlay so you can see. And for you to see what the effect was, by using this adjustment brush, I can come over here and I can turn on and off the brush adjustments. There's the before and there's the after. It's subtle, but it gives more pop to the picture. The other thing I want to do is, before I do anything else, I'm going to use the spot removal tool and get rid of the reflection of the neon sign. So I come over here to the right, click on the spot reduction tool, and I'm going to make the size pretty big. And I'm just going to, as you see, brush over it. And then Lightroom has chosen an area that I don't want for cloning and healing, or for healing of this spot. So I'm going to move it over here and basically line up the lines in the reflection. Oh, I had it, and then I moved it. We move it back slowly but surely, inch by inch. Okay, you get the idea. So at that point, I'm going to click Done. And I would have been a little bit more careful to get this area out as well, but again, for time purposes, I'm going to leave it there. Let's see, the next thing that I want to do is I'm going to use a radial filter. And the radial filter, and whenever you click on a local adjustment tool, make sure you zero it out. And to do that, because it always loads the last one used, just double click on effect and it zeros out all the sliders. Radial filter, and I want, it's going to be a new one, and I want to use it to highlight the train even more. So I'm going to drag this shape and let go, and I'm going to move it here, and then I'm going to angle it a little bit. And to do that, I just hover over the end, and you'll get the little anchors at the end, as you see, and move it around until I'm happy with it. I might even drag this a little bit more. Okay, move this around. And then what I'm going to do is move this. Let's see. I'm going to come back and I'm going to use, where is it? Custom. And I'm going to use Enhance. No, I'm sorry, I'm going to use focal point preset. You see that these presets also work for the radial filter, as well as for the adjustment brush, as well as for the gradient filter. So you can see here that it's lightened up and added more clarity to the train, or the train bay, so to speak. I'm going to hit done. And actually, let me go back because I want to see if I can, there you go, before and after. There's the before and there's the after. So it just directs your focus a little bit more here. So done. Then I'm going to come into sharpening. Okay, so I'm going to come down to detail. And with the sharpening, I want to, let me move my cursor to an area where I can see what's happening with the sharpening. How about in here? Does that work? Okay, so I'm going to pull the sharpening up quite a bit, okay, just for fun. Hang with me for a minute. But I'm also going to mask most of it. I just want the outlines, and I did this last week. It's selective sharpening, so I hold down on my Mac the Option key, and I slide the masking slider all the way over to the right, and where it is white, that is where sharpening is being applied. That is selective sharpening. I'm also, you can play with the radius. Same thing, hold the Alt or Option key down, and you can change, again, if I'm all the way up, you can see there's more, the radius of the sharpening is larger, so I'm going to bring it down. You know, I don't want too much sharpening because I don't want too much noise in the photo, or add noise because it's an iPhone photo. And the detail has the same thing. You slide to the right. I don't know if you can see it. slide to the left, less detail. So I'm going to select this point about here and let go of my Option key. Let's see, for the last thing I'm going to do is going to apply a post-crop vignette, and let's come over here into Effects, and I'm just going to decrease this slightly. So at this point, I am done with the photo, and let's do the before and the after. So a pretty big difference, and pretty good result with the iPhone 6. So I hope you have enjoyed the video. I hope I have you've learned something new. And if you care to leave any comments, please do so in the comments section on my blog, or if you're watching this on YouTube, on my YouTube channel. And for viewers on YouTube, if you want to see more After Before Friday photo galleries, please visit my blog, visualventuring.com, and look for After Before Friday in the menu. Thanks for watching, everybody.